This is going to be a very fun Cotton Bowl. It will be the fourth all-time meeting between Tulane and USC. Tulane playing in its first major bowl game in 83 years and looking to win its first major bowl game since beating Temple in the Sugar Bowl way back on January 1st, 1935. And a win will go a very long way for Michael Pratt and this Tulane football program after what they've been through over the last year.
My first year here, we were 6-6. My second year, we went 2-10, and now this year we're sitting at 11-2. So kind of just seeing, you know, every different aspect of success and knowing what it takes to be successful and seeing the steps that everybody's made to get to this point.
I think it's really been the kind of the 1-0 mentality, you know, all season long. Coach Fritz has done a good job with, you know, keeping the guys focused on the task at hand. And I think that's part of the reason why, you know, it's been somewhat of a nameless, faceless opponent week in and week out and just focusing on what we do best and executing at a high level.
Jim Svoboda has had the Tulane offense executing at a high level in his first season as Tulane's offensive coordinator, leading the second highest scoring offense in school history, averaging more than 35 points per game.
This is the first time for these players running this offense, and the fact that they've done it with the level of efficiency and taking care of the football, we're not heavily penalized. We don't hurt ourselves very much. We've been productive in the red zone. And as you mentioned, we've been, you know, and there's been a few games where we've, you know, taken our foot off the gas a little bit too in terms of points this year.
The Tulane offense has put up at least 42 points in five different games this season and a season high 59 points in a win over SMU. Now the USC defense, well, they give up some points, 28 points per game, which ranks 82nd in the country. In Arlington, Sharif Ishak, WDSU News.